Sabini. Nani mwingine aongeze? Nani mwingine aongeze? Hiyo ng'ombe inatosha zaidi ya sabini. Aya. Sabini mara ya kwanza. Sabini mara ya pili. Aya, mara ya tatu kwa huyo. Enda andikisha. Mara ya kwanza nione. 45. 30. Tuko hamsini sasa. Hamsini na tano. Hamsini na tano. Hamsini na tano. Sitini.
125.
Mara ya kwanza. 125. Mara ya kwanza. 130. Mara ya kwanza. 130. 140. Mara ya kwanza. 140. Mara ya pili. 140. Mara ya tatu.
We are here for a public auction of livestock. And the livestock range from dairy cows, Asia. We also have beef, sahiwal. We also have milk goats, Drakensberg. And we also have a sheep, that is Doba, that we are selling. The purpose of this auction mainly is actually to sell to farmers quality breeds of livestock for purposes of them improving their breeds and their livestock at home. Every year we do an auction here in Chebororwa. To empower our farmers in the neighborhood and also within the county and the neighboring counties. Remember, ATC Chebororwa, as a training institution, serves farmers from all over the region. Training here is not restricted to farmers from the county, and also the sale of livestock is also not restricted to farmers within the county, but generally farmers within this region who would want to improve their breed. We know in Elgeyo Marakwet here, just in our neighborhood, we have dry areas that are good for rearing beef cattle. And you would see that a majority of the farmers who are interested in our bulls, especially the several bulls, are likely from the drier parts of the region, which is good as an economic activity for the region. What has surprised me apparently in this auction is the number of women who are here to buy the milk goats, the token pack. And I was so shocked to learn that a liter of goat milk is actually going for 40 bob here in rural. If we have to maintain a healthy population, then we need to encourage families to keep a few, just even for domestic consumption. But you see, you'll be tempted when the prices are good, you'll be tempted to sell. It has also surprised me that a milk goat can go for 50,000. And I was telling my farmers here, then why should you be struggling with maize that will give you 60,000 for a whole year? If you can rear one goat that gives you 50, suppose you have 10. And you know, this one, si hakuna kusumbukana, 1 acre inatosha, unalisha tu hapo nyumbani, mahindi kidogo, na busa inanga ugonjwa mingi. Wewe utapambana tu na kupe kidogo, and because you are, there is almost zero movement, you are unlikely to experience matters of disease. So I think that is something that I've learned here. And I think we are going to sit with my Department of Agriculture to see how we can now upscale actually breeding in this ATC so that our farmers can get enough of livestock to buy. The competition here was very tight. We are farmers who will go home without getting livestock to buy. So I think it is a challenge on us, on government, so that we can increase the number of livestock to the extent that when we sell to farmers, and particularly for purposes of breeding, because we have numbers, we shall lower the prices. Because of the competition that was here, the prices were so high, even for our common farmers. And I think it is something that going forward, we want to sit with my Department of Agriculture and see how we are going to enhance this ATC in terms of increasing the number of breeding stock so that we can avail to our farmers at a cheaper rate. I know in this financial year, the Department of Livestock is investing in more than 200 Doba sheep for breeding, so that in the next year, we shall have enough stock to sell to our farmers. Our role is to bring quality breeds and pass to our farmers. So Chebororwa is not per se here to do business, but they are actually here to breed and make it available to our farmers. And that is what we are concentrating. We hope to make this a center of excellence for coffee production besides livestock, avocado, and macadamia. Our intention, within the next 2 years, we should have 100 acres of coffee here, we should have 100 acres of avocado, and we should have 100 acres of macadamia. This is the region that is good for that, so that we can commercialize and show our farmers that it is possible to do that. Although some farmers are already harvesting and enjoying the fruits of diversification, but we think we need to boost that exercise.
Niko na 5,600 hapa. Haya saba. Yeah. Niko na mtoto. So, itaenda na mtoto. Haya, sawa, sawa. Haya. Haya. 2,500 mara ya kwanza. 22 kwa nani?
25
hapa. 25 mara ya kwanza. 25, 26, 30. Mara ya kwanza, mara ya pili, mara ya tatu.